die. You're going to live and live and live forever and never, ever die. It's quite a reward. Then verse 51, I am the living bread which came down from heaven. Christ says that He's that bread. If any man eat of this bread, he shall live forever. Now, those are the words of Jesus Christ Himself. And He says, now, if you eat this manna, this hidden manna, you are going to live forever, and you're going to be unlike this world that is everybody is deceived. Satan has deceived the whole world. 2 Corinthians 4 and verse 4 says he's the god of this world. And Revelation 12:9 is where it talks about him deceiving the whole world. So they don't understand the spiritual manna. They almost all of them think they do, and they're all religious, but God says they don't understand it. They don't really understand about this hidden manna. They don't get it because it's a mystery. It's hidden from them. And why is it hidden? Why would God do that? Hide the mystery from them. Well, if God opened their minds today, for most people, they wouldn't lose their salvation. So God is going to call them when it's the most propitious time for them, and that's His plan, and you can read that in our booklet on the Holy Days if you'd like to write for it. God has a master plan, and He's going to save most of humanity, but He's going to do it in His time frame and not ours. And that's a wonderful plan. But look, those people that are resurrected and called in that second resurrection are not going to be given the reward of marrying Christ and ruling over all the nations, because it is these people that are called out today that eat that hidden manna that are going to be ruling with Christ and helping those people understand what the spiritual manna is all about as the bride of Jesus Christ. In that second resurrection, He's going to open their minds. Everybody will have this open to their minds then, but that's not the case today. It's hidden from them today. It's a mystery to them. Notice that in John 7, verse 37. In that day, that great day, in the feast. Well, what is that talking about? Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. Now, that's not going to be hidden manna then, but he's talking about the last day of the last day of the Feast of Tabernacles. It's a separate holy day. The white throne judgment is what it's all about, and it happens at the end of the millennium when God is going to resurrect billions of people. And then at that time, after he's set everything in order on this earth for 1,000 years and made this earth just the ultimate paradise, he's going to resurrect all of those billions and billions and billions of people, and he's going to tell them, okay, now here is the spiritual manna, and everybody will understand it now. But he says today, almost none of them do. That is God's plan. You'll read it, and you can read about it in that Holy Day booklet if you'd like to write for it. And I'll tell you, it really tells you all about God's master plan. And that's what this world needs to understand, that master plan. That when God is going to resurrect billions and billions of people, your relatives and family and friends that have died, and many of them never knew God. And many of them thought they did and really did not. But everybody's going to have a chance, God says, to know about this manna. I mean, that wouldn't be fair if God hid it from them and never gave them a chance to understand it, would it? Well, I don't think it would, and God doesn't either. So it isn't. So you need to get that booklet, though, if you don't have it, and find out about God's plan for all of mankind. And it is something that will just make you ecstatic when you understand it. I can guarantee you that. Notice Exodus 16 and verse 35. And the children of Israel did eat manna 40 years, until they came to a land inhabited. They did eat manna until they came into the borders of the land of Canaan, or the promised land. So they ate that manna all the way to the promised land. And then they entered into the promised land, a physical promised land. But God says, now today you eat that spiritual manna, and I'm going to lead you into the spiritual promised land where you'll live forever. Forever. And if you come along today, if God called you today and you respond to that call today, He's going to give you the most exalted office that you can even imagine to help Him rule over the rest of humanity and teach them this marvelous truth. See, these people in ancient Israel died. They're dead. And He says they never understood eternal life. He didn't give them His Holy Spirit. They could never have understood it spiritually, but they could have done a lot better on the letter of the law level, but they still rebelled. But that whole nation proved that mankind can never make life work, even if God is guiding them. If they don't have the Spirit of God and are able to eat that hidden manna that fills the void in their lives and gives them real purpose and real hope in their lives. So let's look now at another scripture that relates to this, Deuteronomy 31 and verse 9. Here is what Moses wrote, and Joshua followed him. Verse 9, and Moses wrote this law and delivered it unto the priests, the sons of Levi, which bear the ark of the covenant of the eternal, and unto all the elders of Israel. So Israel had this ark of the covenant, and that seat was covered with gold because it was a type of God's throne, a type of His throne. And you know what was in that ark? You can see 2 Samuel 6 and verse 2 says it's a type of His throne, but it's actually a replica of the very throne of God in heaven. But inside that ark, which is a type of God's throne, they had the law, the Ten Commandments. They had the rod of Aaron, which was a symbol of the government to implement that law. And then they had the manna. So if you see there, it tells you how we can receive that hidden manna today, or understand it and discern it, and then apply it in our lives and eat it and live forever. But we have to, you see, it all comes together. It comes with the law, the government, and then God feeds us manna if we follow that formula. Now that's what it's all about. You see, if you really want real freedom, God says, true freedom, priceless freedom, then you need to keep the law. There's no freedom without the law. And yet the whole world still does not understand that God wants to give us true freedom. He wants us to really be free, free from human nature and sins and all these terrible addictions we get ourselves into that just wrecks our lives. And God doesn't want us to live that way. Well, He doesn't live that way, and He certainly doesn't want us to. Notice verses 28 and 29. Gather unto me all the elders of your tribes and your officers, that I may speak these words in their ears and call heaven and earth to record against them. For I know that after my death you will utterly corrupt yourselves and turn aside from the way, that the way of the manna, which I have commanded you, and evil shall befall you in the latter days. What's that? Evil shall befall you in the latter days. This is Moses talking in the first five books of the Bible called the Pentateuch. He says, evil will befall you in the latter days, the day we're living in right now. Isn't that amazing that Moses told us about all these problems? Because you will do evil in the sight of the Lord to provoke Him to anger through the work of your hands. So this is just a marvelous prophecy for the latter days. And would you believe, can you believe, Moses made the prophecy and told us what would be happening to us. And this includes America and Britain and the Jews in the Middle East. Yes, it does.